Early on, it started with just using basic data, so box scores, play-by-play, and then a lot of sports in recent years have what's called player tracking data, meaning we have locations of the players on the court or on a pitch or on a field, whichever sport we're talking about, in at a high resolution. So from that data, we can extract not only things that are counted in a box score, but also other things that happen during the game that you wouldn't see counted in like a basic box score, for example.
What are some of the common questions that like coaches or owners come to you with?
The biggest question is, how do we value players? How do we find which players which teams should sign, which how long of a contract, how much money should be on a contract? So that's one side. So that's the player evaluation side. And then the other side is coaching and in-game decision making. So which situations are producing the most value for the teams? Which situations are creating better opportunities to score?
I know, like in baseball, Major League Baseball, and in minor league baseball, now it's coming into all the other parts of baseball, the analytics people, the data people, versus maybe some of the more traditionalists, and they kind of butt heads on occasion. And how much analytics do you use? Imagine knows what I'm talking about. So how much analytics do you use versus just my gut, I think this player will do well? Or how do you kind of bridge that topic?
Yeah, so that's a big important thing, because you can't just have data without domain expertise. And I think that's something that we at Zelus have a really good strength, is that we have the experts in data, in statistics, in AI, in machine learning. But we also have a lot of people who worked in sports teams and have that sort of experience and know which questions the teams want to answer, what's useful for them, and how can we help them best.
So, yeah, because when you were saying what AI could help you do, it feels like, isn't that what a coach is supposed to do? But you're saying that you need someone to interpret how to manage that and stuff.
Right. So you need like a bridge between the data and what's happening on the court.
All right, if I'm an agent representing a player, now I got to learn this stuff, because the team's going to come at me and say,
this is what the program tells me that I need to be on
my client. Yeah, your
client's
worth blank because his or her OPS is this and blah, 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 blah. And you got to come back and say, no, I think he's better than that, and I think he's worth more. So do you work with the agents and players themselves as well? Because they better be smart on this stuff.
Yeah, that's a great area where Zelus is growing as well in some of our sports. But yeah, it's not, you know, an agent cannot learn all of this on their own. So having a company or a contractor who can
help. So do you guys work with agents and players and directly?
In certain sports, yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
But not all across the board. So you also, as Paul was mentioning earlier, you got your BS and your PhD in applied mathematics at NJIT. Woof.
That hurts just thinking about it.
Because we're here and we're talking about how NJIT kind of bridges the gap between learning stuff and then putting it out into the world, how did this help you evolve your career and leave you where you are today?
Yeah, even though I studied computational fluid dynamics, it's not exactly data science, but I've learned a lot of skills that
we
help me
transition.
We would not
know the difference, by the way, so you can pretend that they're the same.
There's a lot of skills that transfer from one field to the other. For example, coding, analyzing large data sets, creating visualizations, and communicating scientific results to a regular audience, to anybody else who can understand it.
Are there some sports that are embracing AI or just technology analytics more than others?
I think that's historically been baseball, particularly because they had the more advanced
data
for the
yeah.
longest
mm.
time.
Yep.
But other sports now also have the player tracking data and are starting to get more on that side.
How did you wind up in this? Because if you played basketball, right? Because you're originally from Croatia, right?
Correct.
So you played basketball, and then you somehow wound up deep into analytics. How did you do that?
Well, I always loved math, and I always loved basketball, and this was a perfect combination of the two.
Huh. So I'm kind of wondering, where are we, do you think, in terms of the evolution of applying data and AI to sports? Because it just the statistics, I've been following sports my entire life, and I'm listening to a broadcast, and they're saying stuff I have no idea what they're talking about. Like, now batting average isn't important anymore to baseball, and now it's on base plus slugging. I don't know. I mean, it seems like we need a tutorial on a lot of these broadcasts. I mean, where can this go, do you think?
Yeah, I wouldn't know about baseball because I don't really understand the rules coming from Croatia. But in basketball, we for now we have the player location data, but it's also growing towards player kinematics data, which NBA has available starting this season. Kinematics.
And what's kinematics?
So the locations of players. Wrist, elbow, shoulder, all of the joints.
Oh.
So more detailed data of like player movements and so how players are shooting and you can extract all this more detailed information, and that's the next step in basketball. Yeah, yeah, yeah.